H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
So we basically spoke about a generic service method that is your service and which takes your HTTP request and HTTP response. Okay. So a request is, so till now we haven't seen what is the use of request. We have only spoken about what is a response. So you can see here the moment you give a request. So that means from your browser, you give a request. The request comes to the service method. Okay. And from the response, your request comes to the service method and you're not doing anything with the request because you're sending something, but you are not capturing those informations. Okay. From there, you are with the help of your response, you are basically saying response.getWriter because you want to give some response back to the browser. All right. So when you say response, you response.getWriter, you basically create an output stream. And with the help of output stream, you basically say out.println. Right. So today we are going to see what is the use of request, okay, and see how we can use it effectively and how usually in the real time also it happens, okay. For that reason, what am I going to do is I am first going to create. Wait a minute. Just a minute, guys. Don't do monocular particular. Yeah, sorry, guys. There was some disturbance. Okay. So today we are going to see how we are going to use this request object and what is the use of it. Okay. So the very first thing what I'm going to do is I can very well use the same servlet out here. Okay. And we will try to give some request to this particular servlet or give some values to the servlet so that this servlet can capture those values. Okay, so as of now, let me go back to your web.xml, and as we have seen yesterday that in your web.xml also you can basically manipulate the URL pattern. Okay, otherwise you can even use the annotations. Okay, so as of now, let me just comment this out. All right, and we will start working with your annotations itself. Okay. Now here I have my annotations here, and there is a hello.html, and from your hello.html basically nothing happens, right? So but I want to do something from my hello.html. okay, so what do I do from my hello.html? I want to basically enter some informations. I'll just use a form here. Form in the sense it's kind of a tag in HTML, if you guys are pretty much good at HTML. So we are going to see that. Okay. So how do you basically create a form? You basically create a form inside the body, right? So you just say form, okay? And that you basically say action, the one action which we are going to see is I'm just going to copy this one, okay? Come back and just paste it out here. And I'm just going to say method as, let's say post. We'll talk about this as well. And then I'm just going to say input type equal to text. Okay. Name equals to, let's say I'm going to say first name. Okay. And then let me just give a break out here. And again, just copy this and paste it out here. And this is your last name. All right. And at last, I'll be having a input type equal to submit, value equals to submit. Okay, so what did I do is I basically created an HTML file, and with the help of that HTML file, what am I going to do is I'm going to give the first name, the last name. All right, once I give the first name and the last name, I just want to submit that page. So as a result, what I want to do is I want to capture the information which has been submitted from this form. Okay, so this is an HTML form in which you can basically give all the inputs. Okay, so this is the placeholder wherein you can type in something so that you can send it to the server. All right, so if I go back, if I just run this application right now, right click, run as, run on server. Okay, as usual process, next. Let me remove this and just keep my web pro, finish. So how many of you successfully installed everything and at least created a file, a servlet file or an HTML file, and executed that in the server? You guys can just say yes. Great, Lydia. Okay, great. I see a good amount of people. Okay, so how do we access that? Localhost 8081 and WebPro, and you have your hello.html. Okay, so if I just remove this, hello.html. Okay, now I hope I have this. Okay, I'm not accessing this one. Let me even remove this. All right, I haven't checked in the file yet. Probably I'll be doing it from now, because till date we were just talking about the basics. Okay, all right, so here if you see, I've got hello H2K students, that's what you get it from here. This is also not required for me. Okay, just leave it. So I've got a form out here, and you just say input type equal to text, name equal to first name, input type equal to text, name equal to last name, okay, L name and first name, and input type equal to submit. So this is a button which basically comes up whenever you use submit. Okay, so what's my objective is, the moment I do a submit, what should happen? It should go to the servlet, right? So that's what basically happens in every web application. You give some information in your web page. When you do a submit, it goes to a particular, it goes to a server, and somebody is responsible to take those informations. Okay, now what am I going to do right now is, as I have mapped something out here, that is the action equal to hello students, right? So what happens basically if I just do a submit out here, so let us go to the logs here, and okay, let me just say source, clear this and go to my browser and just say submit out here. Okay, so when I did a submit, I got some response back, no doubt, because what happened here, if you can see the URL out here, initially the URL was hello.html. Now when I did a submit, the response, the URL is hello student. So where from the hello student is coming up? Because in our HTML we gave the form action. So whenever you do a submit on this particular form, this forms get submitted. So what do you mean by this form? The entire data which is present in your form. So if you have multiple input or maybe a checkbox or anything as such, all together it goes to your server. Okay, now who is responsible to capture those information? Your hello student is the one which is responsible to capture those information. Okay, as we have already seen that your hello servlet is the one which has been annotated with your hello students. Okay, so as a result, you have your hello student out here which goes and captures all these informations for me. All right, now the next point is, I am invoking my init method. So as you know, this is only going to happen only one time, and if you see, there is an init method. Let me just close all these things. So it is your hello.htm, right? Let me open this file also. Okay, so I have got my init method. Now, as you know, I keep on saying that the multiple time, even if you give a request out here, if I just say continue or keep refreshing this one, okay, I'm just refreshing this page. The moment I refresh, every time the service method is going to get invoked, but only one time in the complete lifecycle of a particular servlet, the init method is going to get invoked. Okay, now how do I capture those informations? I have a request object out here, or request reference out here. So what do I do with the request object? So I just say request dot get parameter, right? Now request.get parameter of what? The first name. All right. Now I know that
the last virus database has been updated.
I know that from my HTML, what am I passing out here? I'm passing a text out here, right? So just watch carefully here. I'm passing a text out here. So I know that the return type of this particular get parameter will be some string itself. Okay. But if you see here, the return type out here is again your string get request.get parameter. So I just say here string first name equals to so and so. Okay. In your previous versions of your servlet, initially we used to typecast this particular request in form of your object. Okay. Because initially the get parameter used to give in the form of an object. So we used to very well typecast this to a string. So if you see any old applications doing it in this way, it's always okay. All right. Now I got my first name, I got my last name. So I'll just copy this, paste it here and just say last name. So request.get parameter of last name. So this particular field corresponds to the name of the input type text. Okay. So the one which you give it here, the same thing you are supposed to access it from there. So you say request.get attribute of first name, request.get attribute of last name. Okay. So what do I do out here? I just say hello. So I simply say first name is the first name and the last name is last name. Okay, so I'm done with my using my request object out here. So what did I do with the request object? With the help of the request object, I took the parameters from my HTML, okay, that is from a form, the one which you have submitted, and that's what I'm doing. I'm just trying to print it outside so that it goes to the console. Okay, even I can print it to the console also. Right now I'm just printing it to the output stream, so my output stream is nothing but your browser. Okay, so go back to the HTML right now. Go back here, I just say Jairam Raut and do a submit. So what did I get here? Apart from getting all this information, I just got first name is Jairam, last name is Raut. Okay, pretty much simple, guys. Okay, so no complications here at all. Okay, now if you see this page, the moment I requested something, okay, I'm not getting anything in the URL. Okay, so now we'll do one more thing. We will just try to pass this instead of using an HTML. What did we use here? We used an HTML here. From the HTML, we gave the first name and the last name, right? That's what it happened. I gave the first name, I gave the last name, and then I submitted. Instead of that, I will not use my hello.html. How do I access my servlet? And I want to pass the first name and the last name in the to the server. Okay. In that case, what I can do is I just say question mark. Okay. First name equals to Ramesh. Okay. Ampersand last name equals to Dan. Okay. Now you see that the moment I gave anything in the URL also, I'm able to access those information. So there are two ways. Okay. Usually you will do it in the form itself. So even though if you do not want to, there's a way of accessing it or passing on these parameters. Okay. So the first name and the last name, you can even pass it using my URL also. All right. So I'll just remove this and remove this. Okay. But usually you don't do it in this way. You very well use a form in order to add some informations. Because if you are a technical guy, if you want to debug something and don't want to come to your HTML file directly, want to jump up to the servlet, you can very well do it in that way. Okay. Now, here, if you observe here, the one thing which we have used is your action. The other one which we have used is your method equal to post. Okay. Now, When you use method equal to post, let us go back to the hello.html itself. Okay, so this is your first name, last name. So you don't see anything in the URL, right? Apart from your root context and the name of the servlet, because this is what we have given here, action equals to so and so. Okay, now what if I use another method, that is your get? Okay, what if I do not use anything as such, first of all? Okay, now when I do not use anything as such here, go back, refresh this page, just say Jairam and Raut, and do a submit. Right now, when I do a submit, if you see here on the URL, the first name and the last name equals to Raut, which comes into picture out here in the URL itself. Okay, as a result, if you do not use any kind of action, any kind of method name, by default the name of the method is get. Okay, and if you explicitly use it as a post, okay, if you explicitly use it as a post and do a submit right now, okay, you do not see anything in the URL. Okay, there is a limitation, I will even talk about those things. So let me first use get. Now there is a difference, why do we need to use, when do we need to use get and when do we need to use post? Okay, now go back, refresh this page. Okay, now when I use get, or if I do not use anything, by default the name of the method is get. Okay, but if I explicitly say it is a post, it will be a post method. Okay, now if you have a get, if you can see, when you use get, the URL comes into picture. When you use post, the URL, the complete information does not come in the URL. Okay, now why, in case right now you have only two data, right, that is your first name and the last name, usually in a form you will be having bunch of data. Okay, and sending the data in the URL has got some limitations. You cannot keep on sending the whole, let's say 1 MB or 2 MB of data. Okay, so it has got some limitations, which we'll even talk about it. Okay, all right, so what next? We spoke about first name, last name, we submitted that and we got the information in the servlet and we are able to proceed. All right, now when in particular you talk about, now we have just used a very generic method, that is a service method, okay, which does all the things. Okay, but in order to do your specific requirement, you even have do get as well as your do post method also. Okay, now let us do one thing, let us comment this out, okay, and go back to the HTML, and if you see, the method which I'm using right now is your method equal to get. Okay, now I know that there is a service, there is one more service method, that is your do get. You do not say it is a service method, but it is a do get, but it is by itself is a service method itself. So what do you mean by service method? Service method is the one which takes a request each and every time you send a request to that particular servlet. Okay, and it gives a response back to you. Okay, so as of now, let us uncomment this and comment this out here. So let me all remove all these things. Okay, and take up these informations, the same information what we had it in the service method, and post it here. Okay, so the same thing, it is going to come to this service method, that is a doGet, because we have used a doGet here explicitly. Okay, and come back to the HTML, and we have used a method equal to get here. Come back to the HTML back, okay, in the browser, and just do a submit. Okay, so let me just give some meaningful message so that we differentiate that it is a get or a post. I'll just say in get. Okay, so go back, refresh this and do a submit. All right, so it says in get. Now what happens if I just go back to the HTML and replace this name to post? Okay, so go back to the browser, refresh this. Now if I How do you still, if it is an HTML code, you can very well right click on this and just say view page source.